In this example, we're going to try to find the equation of a tangent line, but the catch is the tangent line is not going to be tangent to a function like it typically is. It's going to be tangent to an equation that's defined implicitly. So that's going to create a little twist here. So let's just remember the basics first about tangent lines. So obviously, for a tangent line, we just need a point of tangency, and we also need the slope of the tangent line, the slope of the curve at that given point. So when we have those two things, we can write the equation of the line, after some algebra, as y equals mx plus b. Now, to find the m, the slope of the tangent line, what we typically do is take f prime of x. We take the derivative of the function, and then that's your m. But as you see with this orange graph here, this is not a function. If you recall, a function passes the vertical line test, which means if you pass a vertical line from left to right across the function, it only intersects at most one place. Think like the x squared graph or the sine graph. A vertical line only intersects those graphs at one point at most. But here is crossing not once, not two times, but three times. So this is not a function. So this concept of f prime doesn't really make sense. Now there obviously is a slope here, but to get the m, then we're gonna have to use implicit differentiation. So that's the only twist. And then after that, once we have our m, then we can use the point that's provided to find the y-intercept for the tangent line, which would be somewhere else. Okay, so here's an example. This is defined implicitly. Implicitly means it's not y equals some function of x where you only have x's on the right-hand side. You see, we have x's and y's intermingled here. So first step is to take the derivative. Now, if you are unfamiliar with implicit differentiation in the previous video, I cover how to do implicit differentiation. So we're going to assume you guys know how to do that right here, but now, the first term would be the product rule. We'd have derivative of the first, 6x times the second plus the first, 3x squared times the derivative of the second. Now, the derivative of y is 1, but when we differentiate with respect to x, it would leave a dy dx because we're differentiating with a different variable with respect to x. Minus 6 equals 2y, again, dy dx from implicit differentiation. So I see the dy dx is here. Here's one and here's one. So the steps go like this. We're going to sort these terms. We're going to put everybody that has a dy dx on one side, and everybody who does not have a dy dx will move to the other side. So this term and this term do not have a dy dx, so let's put those on the right. We'll have 6 minus 6xy, and then I'm going to move the terms with the dy dx to the left. And if you don't mind, at the same time, I'm also going to pull out that common factor of dy dx that they have. So I have 3x squared minus 2y. 3x squared minus 2y. As I move this to the left, and they both have a dy dx, so I factored it out. So dy dx would be 6 minus 6xy all divided by 3x squared minus 2y, something like that. So now this will give me the slope at any given xy point. And luckily, they provide one for us. This will be the point of tangency, 1 comma 2. So if we evaluate this at 1 comma 2, then we would get dy dx equals, let's see, a little mental math here. 6 times 1 times 2 is 12, so that's negative 6 divided by 3 times 1 is 3, minus 4 is negative 1. So we get a slope of positive 6, slope of positive 6. Now that's just the m equals 6, and the point was the point 1 comma 2. So from here, the way that we get the equation of the tangent line is we'll use probably a little bit better to use the point slope form here. Y minus y1 equals m. parentheses x minus x1, since the point I had was not a y-intercept. So slope-intercept form would certainly work if you did a little algebra, but I think this will just be a little quicker. We have y minus 2, that's the given y value. This is x1, y1, equals 6 parentheses x minus 1. So y minus 2 equals 6x minus 6. So y equals 6x minus 4. And I feel fairly confident in this answer because on the one hand, I know that the slope of 6 agrees with that implicit equation or the graph of that implicit equation at 1, 2. And I also know if I plug in a 1, 6 minus 4 is 2. So this point of tangency is also on my tangent line as well. So that's how we go about finding the equation of a tangent line for some equation that's defined implicitly, that's not originally a function if it doesn't pass the vertical line test.